Before I get down to today's video, I have two announcements to make. Number one, for the foreseeable future, I will not be making any more music videos. I want to get back into focusing on making reviews and discussions. Number two, I recently made some channel art, and a friend of mine asked me, can I get that on a t-shirt? So that's what I did. And if you don't feel like a t-shirt, that's cool, I got other stuff there too. The link will be down in the description box below.
Yeah, I'm doing a little product placement. I gotta get paid too.
If you find yourself enjoying the video at any point, do not forget to leave a like and also to subscribe. And hit the bell icon so you can stay updated on all my future releases. Also, follow me on Twitter at RtasIntent and on Instagram at GeneralRtasVadam. Hey guys, it's Rtas here, back with another video. Don't worry, I'm still here and I will still be making content.
Nothing's changed!
And in today's video, seeing as I've already covered my top 10 moments from Dragon Ball Super's anime, I thought I would switch gears and talk about the manga. Specifically, today I will give 8 instances where I thought Dragon Ball Super's manga surpassed its anime. Number 1, the handling of the Resurrection F arc. I, like I'm assuming the majority of the community, was not pleased to learn that the first two arcs of Dragon Ball Super were going to be recapping the movies. And because of that, I tuned out of the series until the Universe 6 tournament. But when I read Toyotaro's adaptation of the story, I noticed something. And it was sheer genius. He took the already existing Resurrection F portion of the story and ripped it out of the manga and skipped right to the good stuff. Well played, Toyotaro. And even better, it's not like it's retconned or anything. Whis even mentions it in Chapter 5. But like I said, Toyotaro skipped it and went right to the good stuff. Number 2, the reveal of Super Saiyan Rose. In the anime, we got no explanation as to what Super Saiyan Rose actually was, aside from a sentence.
Of course my eloquence would be lost on the crude ears of mortals.
But in the manga, we get much more clarity, with future Zamasu explaining, when a divine being surpasses Super Saiyan God, instead of turning blue, he turns pink. A much better explanation than what the anime gave us. Entry number 3, actually giving an explanation as to why Vegeta struggled so much in his battle with Hit. The manga's approach made Vegeta seem less like Goku's lesser and more his equal. As the match is quickly going south for Vegeta, Beerus inquires why Vegeta is struggling so much, to which Whis simply explains, Super Saiyan Blue is not a transformation that can be done over and over again in succession. The amount of stamina it consumes makes it a detriment in that regard. And there we have it. Entry 4, the ending of the Goku Black arc. I still don't like the ending of Zeno wiping out Future Trunks' timeline because it renders the entire arc 100% pointless. All the fighting, all the sacrifice, it amounted to nothing. Damn, that's depressing. Anyway, why do I like the ending better in the manga? Well, that's simple, because there's no Sky Zamasu. Rather, somehow he was able to generate like 1,000 clones of himself. Leaving Goku and Vegeta with really no options, they plan to make their last stand while Trunks and the others get back. But then Goku remembers there's the button he got from Zeno, which gives Goku an idea. Since they can't get rid of all the Zamasus, need I say more? Entry number 5, the Zen Expo. I'll be honest, I actually really enjoyed the exhibition fights between Universe 7 and Universe 9 in the anime, but in the manga, we got something way more juicy. A free-for-all between 12 gods of destruction. Though it was short-lived, it was really damn cool to see. Especially seeing Beerus tap into Ultra Instinct. That was something special. And in my opinion, better than the exhibition fights from the anime. And now, my final entry. Number 6. Last, but not least, Gohan's final fight in the Tournament of Power. I'm sure you've all seen in the anime Gohan teaming up with Frieza against Dispo, culminating in Gohan's sacrifice to get rid of Dispo. In the manga, if I hadn't seen it for myself, I would not have believed it. In the manga, we see Gohan going one-on-one, fighting to a draw against Super Saiyan Kefla in his base form. Either it's one of two things. Either Toyotaro is a big fan of Gohan, or he just thought, wait, this is Goku's son. He has Goku's genes, so of course he's going to be an absolute beast. And even though this was Gohan's last fight, he really helped narrow the field. Alright, that is all I've got for this video. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to click that like button. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And click the bell icon so that you can stay updated on all of my future releases. Also, follow me on Twitter and on Instagram. Maybe check out the Rtas Vadam store too. Everything there has been designed by me. Alright, that's all I've got for this video. Peace out.